यदादित्य गतम तेजो,
यदादित्य गतम तेजो
यदादित्य जगत भाष्यते अखिलम, जगत
जगद
भाषते
भाष्यते
अखिल,
अखिल
यच्चंद्रांसि यच्चाग्नौ
यच्चंद्रांसि
तत्तेजो विद्धि मामकम्।
तत्तेजो विद्धि मामकम्।
The splendor of the sun, right? Yad Aditya. Aditya means sun. Sun Devata, Surya Dev. Gatam Tejo. So, the splendor of the sun, which dissipates the darkness of this whole world, comes from me, Krishna is saying. And splendor of the moon and the splendor of the fire are also from me. So, essentially, he's only quoting three devatas here. But by extension, you know that all devatas' energy come from Krishna. Right? Like people do so much analysis on the moon. How much did American government spend? $112 billion in 2012 dollars. Billion with a B. 112 billion to go to the so-called moon. I mean, they went to some rock. They didn't really go to the moon. That's what Prabhupada said, that their moon is quite far away. So they probably went to some rock. There's so many rocks floating, right? So they went to one of those. So the unintelligent cannot understand how things are taking place, but one can begin to be established in knowledge by understanding what the Lord explains here. Everyone sees the sun, moon, fire, electricity. One should simply try to understand that the splendor of the sun, the splendor of the moon, and splendor of electricity or fire are coming from Supreme Personality of Godhead. In such a conception of life, the beginning of Krishna consciousness lies a great deal of advancement, right? In such a conception of life, there is a great deal of advancement. For who? For the conditioned soul. Remember, two verses ago we said conditioned soul. So just like a addict, drug addict is to be sent to de-addiction camp, we have to come to deconditioning camp. And ISKCON is a deconditioning camp. So we are in that camp right now. Some people are so conditioned, they want to escape from the camp. Some are jumping out of the windows. Some are opening the door and running out. Right? Because although there is opportunity to decondition yourself, some people are not taking the benefit because they are still addicted. Addicted to material world. The living entities are essentially the parts and parcels of Supreme Lord. And is giving here with how, here with the hint, how they can come back to Godhead. Which is back to home. Our home is not here, our home is there. From this verse, we can understand that the sun is illuminating the whole solar system. There are different universes and solar systems. Different suns, moons, planets, but in each universe there is only one sun. As stated in Bhagavad Gita, the moon is one of the stars. Nakshatranam aham Shashi. Shashi means moon, Surya means sun. Shashi Surya Yo. Some people actually name their kids like this, Shashi Surya. Or Shashidhar, right? Shashidhar is sun. Sorry, moon. Or Suryakant. I have colleagues, one is Shashidhar, one is Suryakant. So both of them are sun and moon's names. Sunlight is due to spiritual effulgence in the spiritual kaya of the Supreme Lord. Why? Spiritual effulgence. It's the light of the Lord. His body is so brilliant that it comes to material world as sunlight. Right? So think of it. You do this sixth grade experiments. You take a cardboard, you cut a small hole. You put a table lamp behind the hole, and then how does the light come out from the hole? Can you see the table lamp anymore? No, you just see a pencil of light coming from that hole. I don't know about you, but I did this experiment when I was in high school, right? Just to show how light goes in straight lines, it doesn't bend. It reflects but doesn't bend like that. So, same thing. Spiritual effulgence of the Lord is coming through this tiny portal called the sun. So, you can see that pencil of light coming out. So now think about how bright the lights Lord's body is. Very, very bright. Krishna Surya Saman. Means body of Krishna is equivalent to sun. With the rise of the sun, the activities of human beings are set up. They set fire to prepare their foodstuff, fire to start the factories. So many things are done with the help of the fire. Therefore, sunrise, fire, moonlight are so pleasing to living entities. Without their help, no living entity can live. You cannot live, actually. Even your so-called electricity is also sun's fire. Sun's fire, millions of years ago, converted the dead trees into coal today. And the coal is burnt in the power generation, converted to electricity, which is transmitted to your home, and your light is on. So although your light is an LED light, the source of the energy is the sun. You get the point? So if one can understand that light and splendor of the sun, moon, and fire are emanating from Supreme Personality of Godhead, then one's Krishna consciousness will begin. So to start your Krishna consciousness, you should understand, oh, sun is the light of the Lord. Oh, moon is also the light of the Lord. By moonshine, all vegetables are nourished. Moonshine is so pleasing, people can easily understand that they are living by mercy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna. Without his mercy, they cannot be sun or moon or fire. And without help of sun, moon, and fire, we cannot live. So these thoughts provoke Krishna consciousness in the conditioned soul. Okay. But what they are trying to do right now, they are trying to suppress these thoughts. They'll give some weird reasoning. Human being is so intelligent that we are, you know, harnessing the power of sun in the batteries, and the batteries can now drive your Tesla car forward. Therefore, human beings are very powerful. No, we are not powerful. We are using something that doesn't belong to us. It was created by somebody else, right? The Supreme Lord. So to gradually provoke the thoughts of Krishna consciousness, we have to think about source of the sun, source of the moon. Where is this energy coming from? How much energy does sun have that every day is discharging so much energy, but still is never exhausted, right? Do you see sun saying, okay, sorry, sir, I'm exhausted now. Let me rest for some time. No, it's continuously emitting energy. So without his mercy, we will not have these planetary bodies, and that will gradually evoke our Krishna consciousness within. Gama visyacha bhutani.
Gama visyacha bhutani.
Dharayami ahamojasa.
Dharayami ahamojasa.
Pushnami chaushadihi sarvaha.
Pushnami chaushadihi sarvaha.
It's actually a sandhi. Cha aushadihi. Aushadi means medicine. Cha means also. Also medicines. Sarvaha means all. All medicines are also coming from that energy. That's what he's saying. Somo bhutvara satmakaha.
Somo bhutvara satmakaha.
Ojasa means energy emanating. That's ojasaha. Bhutani means living entities. Right? So what is he saying? I enter into each planet. So Krishna is entering into each planet as Paramatma. Just like there is Paramatma in you and me, there is Paramatma in every atom. And by my energy, they stay in orbit, right? Like I attended a course on moon. And in that course, the professor was saying, so these planetary systems stay in orbit. But he doesn't say why or how. He says they just automatically stay in orbit. Who's keeping them in the orbit? Krishna is keeping them in the orbit. I become the moon and thereby supply the juice of life to all vegetables. So sunlight actually doesn't give the nourishment to the vegetables. It's moonlight, according to Krishna. So vegetables are supposed to grow in the night when moon is bright, that there is some subtle energy that comes from the moon to grow these vegetables. It is understood that all planets are floating in the air only by energy of the Lord. The Lord enters into every atom, every planet, every living being. This is discussed in Brahma Samhita. It is said that one plenary portion of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Paramatma, enters into planets, the universe, the living entity, and even into the atom. So one portion enters. So due to his entrance, everything is appropriately manifested. When the spirit soul is there, a living man can float in the water. But when the living spark is out of the body is dead, the body sinks. See, like if you put a dead body in Lake Samamish, it will immediately sink. But how is the living being able to float on the water? How is the person able to swim? The spark is there. Of course, when it is decomposed, it flows like a straw. That is after a few days, it decomposes and, you know, just comes up. But as soon as the man is dead, he at once sinks in the water. Similarly, all these plants are floating in the space, and this is due to the entrance of the supreme energy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. His energy is sustaining each planet just like a handful of dust. If someone holds a handful of dust, there is no possibility of dust falling. But if one throws it in the air, it will fall down. Similarly, these planets which are floating in the air are actually held in the fist of the universal form of the Supreme Lord. So the Lord is, with some invisible strings, he is playing with these different planets. By strength and energy, all moving and non-moving things stay in their place. It is said in the Vedic hymns that because the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the sun is shining and planets are steadily moving. Were it not for him, all the planets would scatter like dust in air and perish. Similarly, it is due to the Supreme Personality of Godhead that the moon nourishes all vegetables. Due to the moon's influence, the vegetables become delicious. Without the moonshine, the vegetables can neither grow nor taste succulent. According to modern science, moon is just doesn't have its own light, but it's the reflected light from the sun. But the Vedas are saying that it has its own light, own gentle light that it has. Human society is working, living comfortably, and enjoying food due to the supply from the Supreme Lord. Otherwise, mankind could not survive. Right? Despite all our advancement, we still need food to eat. And food supply is due to the Supreme Lord's energy. So in the last line, we said Rasat Makaha. That is very significant. Everything becomes palatable or tasty or eatable by the agents of the Supreme Lord through the influence of the moon. So all the vegetables, where do they get the taste? There are some subtle rays, moon rays that come and make the vegetables tasty. Aham Vaishvanaro Bhutvam.
Aham Vaishvanaro Bhutvam.
Prani Nam Deham Ashritaham.
Prani Nam Deham.
Prana Prana Samayuktaham.
Prana Prana Samayuktaham.
Pachami annam chaturvidam.
Pachami annam chaturvidam.
So, how he is doing pachami? Pachami means digestion. Annam means food. Chaturvidam, four kinds. He is saying prana apana samayuktaha. The balance of the outgoing air and incoming air. Prana is incoming, apana is outgoing. He is balancing them. And then praninam deham ashritaha. So he is saying that he himself joins with the air of life and sits in our soul as Paramatma. Aham Vaishvanaro Bhutva. In the Bhutvas, in different living entities, he is the Vaishvanaraha, means digesting fire. So our stomach has fire in it. If there is no fire, how is it digesting the food? There is fire. And it is digesting four kinds of food. And he's saying that I am that fire of digestion. Without that, you cannot digest food. So according to Ayurvedic Shastra, we understand there is fire in the stomach that digests all food sent there. When the fire is not blazing, there is no hunger. And when fire is in order, we become hungry. Sometimes when fire is not going nicely, treatment is required. In any case, this fire is representative of Supreme Personality.